some on the client presentation, others on the recruiting presentation, so that your knowledge and your confidence is elevated on these areas, right? Because the more you, right, the more seasoned you are, it's like shooting free throws. You go shoot 100 shots, you're going to be better at shooting free throws. So we want you guys shooting free throws here tonight. I want you shooting free throws in the business here tonight, okay? So without further ado, Matt's going to, we called an audible, kind of like a tag team. I'm going to tag Matt. Matt's going to do this for me here. So without further ado, this dude's starting to get a team rolling, right? His eyes are set. His vision's clear on SMD now. This is just one of those guys that's just a ride or die for Team Dominate. Yes. He just is. You know, he's one of those pillars in the office. He's committed. He's consistent. Never see this guy in a bad mood. Just always putting in the work, always trying to get better, always following up, always doing what he's got to do. So if you're on his team, you guys are lucky. So please give a big round of applause to Matt Chang.
You have to look at everything as a whole right now. Look at where you're at and think about where you want your life to be 5, 10, 15, 20 years from now. Right? Nick talked about being completely clear. I told Nick we were just having lunch the other day over at Cosmos across the street. SMD by June 31st and my ring by October 31st. Okay? So that's a public announcement, guys. You guys that are on my team, I appreciate you guys. Let's hurry up and hit SMB. Yeah. The next SMB out of Team Dominate Bay Shop, right? Because no offense to any of the other SMBs that Nick's got. I mean, I want to outwork them.
Yeah.
I want to outwork them, right? And the only way we're going to do the work is by being completely focused on some of the basic fundamentals on how we get more people here and how we help people. Do you guys agree?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to read you guys something from the book I'm reading right now. We were just talking about Tom Hopkins during pregame, right? Tom Hopkins, Low Profile Selling. I have a habit, and you guys know this, of reading a book a month, right? And something I'm going to read from here talks about low profile selling, act like a lamb, sell like a lion. Mm. Something Tom Hopkins talks about in here, I'm going to read it to you guys. Listen and sell with calm enthusiasm. What about that concept, calm enthusiasm? You guys, like, can you be enthusiastic and be calm and saying, yeah, you absolutely could be, right? Wouldn't you agree most people don't think of correlation between calm and enthusiasm? Let's take a closer look. Is there a relationship between the two? Is there such a thing as too much of a good thing, too much enthusiasm? I think so. I always caution my students not to overflow with enthusiasm. You will probably only make a mess of everything. Instead, keep your cup full of enthusiasm, but don't let it slop over where it can damage all your hard work. Mm-hmm. Henry Ford said once, you can do anything if you have enthusiasm. Enthusiasm is the yeast that makes your hopes rise to the stars. Enthusiasm is the spark in your eye, the swing in your gait, the grip in your hand, the irresistible surge of your will and your energy to execute your ideas. Enthusiasts are fighters. They have fortitude, they have staying qualities. Enthusiasm is at the bottom of all progress. With it, there's only accomplishment. Without it, there's only alibis. Now, just something that Nick just mentioned about me is, you guys notice I never have a bad day. You guys ever seen me with a bad day?
No.
No. Sometimes, right, you can be a little frustrated, right? Sometimes when with your business, right, you can be frustrated. Like, I'm frustrated, I don't have, I'm missing one other direct and two other teammates, right? And the only reason why Yannick's not here, because I was going to give him his Fast Start award, his mom had to be airlifted to the hospital earlier today. That's why he's not here. They thought it was a stroke. She didn't have another stroke, thank God. But, he understands the value of being here and being a client. When his dad passed away, they had life insurance. And he's like, I wish we would have had more. We only have 50 grand. I wish we would have had more, right? So today we're going to go over a few things. One, it's in your recruiting efforts. for you to understand how to describe the business model difference between us and Subway, right? And then the other is differences in life insurance. I know we were having that talk, right? I had that talk with Eddie not too long ago. He called, I called that appointment completely 100% on the T for him.
Yeah.
But he replaced a couple PHP policies with, was it Foresters or Foster or something like that? By the way, Eddie, how many apps have you written since April 1st?
It's just three.
Just three. What are the clients' names?
So one of them is Gabriel. Do you need the full?
Yes, first and last name.
Yeah, Gabriel Jimenez.
Oop, that's a J.
Yeah.
I was almost going to put an H. Okay.
Jesus, and then I'll spell out the last name.
That's always a J.
Yeah, M-A-L-D-A-N-A-D-O.
Okay.
And then, okay. Yeah. And then, Tiffany.
I know how to spell that.
Okay.
Last name?
Lopez.
Okay. That's what spillover do you have from last month into this month?
I'm not too sure. Well, just the like, cash flow or points or what?
No. New policies.
Did
you have any spillover?
I have to double check, but I think it's like two of them.
Okay. Well, find out. Let me know.
Okay.
So, Nick, just so you know, that puts us at 15.
Okay. Is it Terry's going to be a spillover?
No, it already advanced.
Okay.
It already advanced. Okay, so we're at 15. That's good. All right.
Yes, sir.
So let's connect to a few things. Let's see, where's my screen, Mary? All right. Just wait for this to catch up. So let's go over a few things. Let's start with, you know, the way we do this. Is it like the right one?
Not 101.
Okay. Yeah. No, I'm just making sure I have the right 101. Because I had the old one in here. I had to swap it up. Okay. Now, when you guys understand our business model, you know, when I talk to people about WFG, it's like describing a franchise.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Kind of like when people think of like McDonald's as well, it's another franchise, you know. And I'm going to tell you, and I'll go through a little bit of the details between us and Subway, right? And then we're going to have a couple of you guys come up and talk about it, because this is the only way we're going to get better. It's we got to get more of you guys doing it more on a consistent basis, right? And that's why we encourage you guys. You guys hear me talk about this all the time: is being in the office, making your phone calls, doing a lot of your appointments from here. Right? Like, I understand you can make your phone calls from home, but sometimes there's just way too many distractions, right? Like, if you got kids, too many distractions, right? Or if you got multiple people that are living in your house, too many distractions, right? So, but that's part of the reason why, even though I only live 10 minutes away from here and I have a home office, I still pay for rent in an office here because I can get a lot more done here, right? But also, too, it's a place for me to conduct business and do one-on-ones, right? So now let's talk about the differences between Subway and WFG. Both very big names, right?
Mm-hmm.
But the main difference between Subway and us is Subway's a franchise, and we're in financial services. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. They have a strong brand name, so do we. They have a simple system, so do we. Right? They make sandwiches. We can if we want, right? But we help families become wealthy. I mean, really, how many franchise type of companies out there are doing what we're doing? Nobody. Yeah, there's companies like, you know, Primerica and PHP, but I mean, in all reality, are they really competition to us? No. And this is getting recorded. It's getting put on my YouTube channel, right? So I'm telling them, no, not even close, right? But now, can you imagine you own a business that you're just making sandwiches every single day because you're an owner-operator of a franchise of a Subway? I mean, really, how fulfilling is that? No, not really, right? Here, we need to help people. Both have ownership, but that's where a lot of the stuff really stops. You know, if you actually look at how to start a Subway franchise, right, and this is me, say, if I'm sitting down with somebody like Eddie and explaining our model versus theirs, it's typically $250,000 to start. Can you imagine that, Eddie? You got $250,000 to start a business right now?
No.
Okay. By the way, that $250,000 gets you a restaurant probably the size of my office. They're really, really tiny if you guys have ever walked into a Subway. Right? Now, not only that, but you're going to have to pay 8% royalty fees, right? Because you're using their name. You also pay franchise fees. Plus, you have to pay for an office lease and you're leasing equipment. Lots of overhead.
Mm-hmm.
Would you agree, Eddie?
Yeah.
Okay, now let's talk about the difference between our model and their model. Right? We also saw ownership. I'm embarrassed to even tell you this, Eddie. It's only $100 to start a business with us. I wish they'd charge $100,000 for it, right? But it's only $100, right? It's what we call an associate membership group. Kind of like how you're paying the $250 for an application with them. $100 application with us to get you started. Okay? There's no royalties, there's no royalty fees, there's no franchise fees, there's no office lease you have to pay for, and there's no leasing of equipment. So less overhead. So what does that mean for you?
More money.
Right, more profits back in your pocket.
Yep.
Right? And that's as simple as it is to compare the two. And sometimes some people, they want to get smart with you. Like, well, you know, this, this, and this. I was like, okay, well, if you really want to go do Subway, by the way, you're committed to owning 2 to 3 more in the next 5 to 10 years. By the way, it's 7 to 10 months before they can find you a location, build it out, and it's 4 to 5 years before you're profitable, making maybe $40,000 a year. Does that make any sense?
No, not at all.
And you have to pay workman's comp.
Yeah, workman's comp, Social Security, FICA, all this other stuff. You got all the stuff. You got all the stuff you got to deal with having employees. Here, Eddie, everybody that you hire and train to essentially open up another franchise for you, they're all 1099, no headaches. Literally. Like, if I ask Nick right now, Nick, am I ever a headache to you?
No. You're what you call low maintenance, high profitability.
You guys understand what that means?
Mm-hmm.
So the only time I really come to Nick is if I'm asking him to do an appointment either for myself personally or for someone on my team and for coaching. Other than that, I'm still putting in the work, I'm still prospecting, I'm still recruiting, I'm still outrunning business.
At every momentum, every full-timers, every pregame.
I never miss a meeting. I think the only times I ever miss a meeting is it's coming out both ends or we're on a company trip. I think I've, in my 8 years, in all reality, I've probably missed maybe 3, maybe 4 BPMs in 8 years. I mean, 8 years this year. Can you believe that already? 8 years, right? But just imagine, Eddie, knowing that you don't have any headaches with employees. You don't have to deal with Social Security. None of that stuff that comes with owning a traditional business.
And dude, you got fans that want you to win, dude. I just posted on Instagram that you launched your SMD run, and SMD's David Valdivia is like, I'm rooting for that guy, blah, blah, blah. I want that guy to win. He deserves it. So yeah, dude, consistency, dude.
Yeah.
You're admired by a lot of people, man. People want you to win.
Yeah.
People got your back, dude.
Yeah. And see, here's the thing is, the only way I know that this is really gonna explode is by helping you guys. You know, whether you're direct to me or on my team or in this office or in the hierarchy, right? It's the only way this team's gonna blow up. And just like what Nick talked about, I'll do whatever it takes. You know, I was already telling my team, I will be up, I can be here at the office early at 7 o'clock and I will stay till midnight. I do not care. You know, my wife's totally understanding, right? But back on subject, it's learning how to really describe the business model in a way that it's simple, that people can understand, like, okay, that makes total sense. Now, I kind of throw in my little, you know, my 2 cents on it. It's, yes, I have an office, I pay $600 for it, but it's a complete tax write-off for it. That's the reason why you go into business, is not only to be profitable, right, but also for the tax advantages. Beauty of being on 1099. You know, and like earlier today, I was setting up my EIN and my S-Corp. That's a whole nother ball game. That's a whole nother ball game. Like you start, because I'm planning on making a multiple six-figure income this year. And I want to keep a majority of my money, right? That's why you go into business. But yeah, I pay for an office lease, but it's a $7,200 write-off every single year, right? but it's a place for me to conduct business, like I said before, and hire and train people, right? And it's mainly for the team, but also too, that's my commitment to the team. I'm gonna be here long term. That's why you get an office, right? That's why you guys got an office, right? But it's, you guys wanna keep it very simple, right? Because the simpler you can keep it, the more people we can recruit. Because you look at, like, we did five recruits, my team, we did five recruits last month, right? So that's five potential clients already, and that's 50 potential appointments. And I'll tell you guys right now, I can't go on all 50. That's when you get good out in the field, you start getting matchups. Right, there was a time where Cynthia was recruiting a lot of people because of the way we do things. I was field training half her team. Similar situation like Alex. He was basically Nick's matchup guy, right? But here, being able to explain this will get you into more markets, bigger team, bigger income, bigger lifestyle, bigger savings, right? You know, and then your vision is stretched a lot more. Like in my business plan, it shows that I want to bring minimum 30 people to convention. So you got a lot of work to do. And the way that's going to happen is we're going to recruit 15 people this month, 25 next month, and then 35 the following month. But I also look at it this way: if that all happens, and based on production, we would hit the SMD quarterly bonus pool too. Because you guys realize when you hit SMD, all those points count toward you being having a big shop, right? So like I go out to SMD, now I'm in Nick's super base being an SMD. So that helps him go into the super base bonus pools, you know, trips and everything, right? But guys, this is so freaking simple. Like a lot of people think, oh my God, I have to know so much. No, you don't, you just gotta know this. You follow this system and it's simple, right? So let's bring up two or three of you guys. We're gonna role play this. And like I said, keep it simple, right? And you want it to a point where everybody can be all on the same page. You want this thing to be humming, right? So let's start with CJ. CJ's like, no. CJ.
Woo!
Yeah. Yes. Yes.
CJ, I believe you can do this, right? Especially because you're working with Arthur. Mm-hmm. Military, structured, you know what has to get done. All you are is just a carbon copy. That's all it is, right? Okay, so go ahead and explain to me, like if you're sitting down with me, explain the differences between Subway and WFG.
Well, Matt, just want to kind of explain some of the differences between Subway, you know, the franchise Subway, and us at WFG. Subway is a franchise. We do financial services. All right. Subway, strong brand name. Everybody knows Subway. We're also a strong brand name. They have a simple system. We have a simple system. They make sandwiches. We could probably make sandwiches as well, but we help families become wealthy. I like that. Works great. All right. As well as, you know, we're both in ownership of our brand. Now, that's kind of where the similarities end. For Subway, you need $250,000 to start. That's just a minimum number. And that'll probably get you a very small location, all right? For us, $100 to start. That already sounds good, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot less. All right, plus on Subway, plus you have to pay 8% royalty fees, plus $15,000 in franchise fee, plus office lease. Y'all are starting to hate that word plus, right? Yeah. Plus leasing the equipment. You know, when all is said and done, you know, how much are you actually paying? You know, a whole lot more than that $250,000. For us, like I said, we started with $100, no royalty fees, no franchise fee, no office lease, and no leasing equipment. Now, how does that sound?
Sounds pretty good.
Now, which out of these two, which one would you prefer? Would you want to go and start your own Subway franchise, or would you like to come with WFG? Now, something else that I didn't point out. Now, notice you're paying all this money right here, right? Do you know how long it takes for you to start?
I'll stop you right there.
Oh, okay.
That's just for your guys' knowledge.
Yeah.
Actually, it's a good thing to know as well.
Yeah, that's just for your guys' knowledge to know that it takes 7 to 10 months for them to find you a location and build it out. And it's literally listed on their website. By the way, there's a lot more requirements, but stopping right there, which makes more sense? Their business model or our business model? Because now they start thinking, okay, well, McDonald's is probably the same way. By the way, if you can even buy McDonald's, it's like $10 million to buy one, right? You look at Jack in the Box, Burger King, Chick-fil-A, like all these other franchises, that's what it starts looking like, right? Versus WFG, okay? Let's have...
That was solid, man. That's good.
Good job.
Yeah,
that's
really good.
Yeah.
Subway versus WFG. Both Subway is a franchise and WFG is in financial services, obviously. Both are very strong brand names. They both have simple solutions, simple systems, I'm sorry. So we both run that. In Subway, you're going to be making sandwiches all day. You don't
That's
look like
exciting.
The sandwich making type to me.
No.
With WFG, we actually help families become wealthy, which I think is something that I know you as a caring person would love to do. They both have ownership. And here's where the differences start. So it's $250,000 to start a Subway, $250,000.
I don't know.
Do you have that in the bank?
No.
Ready to open your own business?
No.
And I'm almost embarrassed to say, but WFG is only $100 to start. So with the Subway, you have plus 8% royalty fees, plus $15,000 in franchise fees, plus office lease, and plus leasing equipment.
That's a lot of overhead.
That's a lot of overhead. So you're altogether putting in more than $250,000. So if you didn't have the $250,000, I'm sure you don't have all the pluses too.
No.
So we come over to WFG. Like I said, it was only $100 to start. No royalty fees, no franchise fees, no office leases, and no leasing equipment. So out of the two, which sounds like a better option?
WFG has a much better business model.
Great, let's get started.
There you go. You guys see, you do this more often, it becomes simpler. It becomes way simpler, right? Okay, we'll do one more, right? How much time do we have? Okay, we'll do one more. Let's have Anthony, why don't you come up?
Okay. Okay, Matt, so we're gonna do this. We're gonna use this Subway example. The reason why we chose Subway is one of the biggest franchises out there. And so we're gonna do this, you know, compare apples to oranges. So we're gonna use Subway versus WFG. So like I said, Subway is a franchise free or financial services. And you know, they have a strong brand name as well as us. Simple system, we have a simple system. Now here's where the difference lies. They make sandwiches, we help families become wealthy.
That's a big difference.
Right? Serving good cause.
Right.
You know, just ownership, you know, they have ownership as well, you have ownership as too. And to get started, you know, your own franchise, it's about $250,000, which, I mean,
that's a lot of money.
Right. And I'm embarrassed to say, you know, to get started with us, it's only $100. And that sets you up with your own personal website, you know, payroll, you know, Transamerica deals with that. So it saves you the headache. On top of that, you know, say you start your own Subway, you have to deal with your own royalty fees, franchise fees, office lease, equipment, permits, and a long list of headaches, which I'm sure you're not, you know.
Yeah, I don't want to deal with all that.
Awesome. Here, no headaches. No royalties, franchise, office, unless if you want to start your own brokerage, which could pay a lot of money. On top of that, you don't have to worry about equipment. So which way is more said? Having your own franchise, you know, business, or your own WG business.
WG sounds way better.
All right, let's get started.
All right, cool. You guys gotta realize there's a reason why we simplified both presentations. You know, I remember that was like, what, 4 years ago, 5 years ago at convention, they said, okay, you can start doing everything e-out. And Nick was like, dude, we gotta figure out how to get all the presentations on PDFs so that it's easier to duplicate, right? Now the question I'm gonna ask you guys is, are you guys role-playing this at home or, you know, with your trainer? You know, I'll take fault for my team, so I'm not doing this enough with my own team. Because if I was, we'd be a lot bigger, right? And I take full responsibility for that. But this is the reason why we do it, so that we can get more people in here. Like Nick's already having me, as we're recruiting people, we're sending people the presentations already. We want them to be familiar with them. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So they can start saying, okay, this is what I'm gonna see when I'm out in the field. And it's also an opportunity for them when they start seeing it out in the field, they can ask questions during their debrief session, mm-hmm. right? Like if you know my team, I tell them, okay, we're gonna debrief for like 10, 15 minutes. You know, you can ask me as many questions as you want. That's how you learn, right? Okay, so that's one. The other one we're gonna talk about today is, of course, one of the more important ones, is your differences in life insurance, okay? Now, when you're out in the field, it's two situations. One, they have life insurance. Two, they don't have life insurance.
Right.
I mean, that's really only, you got two situations. Now, in the situation that they do have life insurance, here's what I will tell you guys to do. Okay, in your KTPs, you ask them, hey, do you have life insurance? And if they say yes, you say, great, I commend you for taking care of your financial responsibilities, but do you really understand how your policy works? Right? And by the way, when's the last time you talked to your agent? You know, you guys want to keep your clients long term? You make sure you talk to them at least every 6 months to 12 months, especially when it's annual review time, because that will lead to more referrals. Right? Like you guys heard me talk about this. Is one of my clients in San Diego, they referred me to one of their friends, their business partners. I have an appointment with them next Monday. So Nick, I won't be here for Phone Zone. I will be in San Diego closing business. Mm-hmm. And the minimum target on that app is 5,000 points. I'm okay driving about an hour and a half to go to San Diego to go write 5,000 points.
Yeah.
And the wife was saying, well, we don't have any kids, so I don't need life insurance. I beg to differ. So I already know that they don't have any life insurance. So guess what? It's going to be a big deal. By the way, they're the business partners to my clients. So guess what they're trying to do? Keep up with the Joneses. Because when somebody has a good thing, right, they want to keep up. Especially if you're in business together, you know, they want to keep up. So now, when we talk about differences in life insurance, there are three different types, especially when it comes to us. First one is term life insurance, right? So like if I'm sitting out, say CJ and his wife. Right, Chris, you're playing CJ's wife today.
Aww, CJ.
So now let's just pretend that they both have term insurance. Okay, because then you can ask them, okay, well, CJ, Krista, how well do you guys understand term insurance? And most people say, well, I know that it's for a certain amount of time, I pay X amount, and if I don't die, I lose out on the money. Right?
Yeah, so that's pretty much what most people say.
By the way, you guys want to get really good and look like you're a natural out in the field, look very professional, ask a bunch of questions. Okay? The KTP and the 101 is, yes, it's filled with a certain amount of statements, but it's about the questions you ask and how they respond. Because how they respond will tell you the next question to ask, so you're directing them in the right direction. That's what all the best closers do. All the best recruiters and the best closers, they're just really good at asking the right questions to dictate which way that the client or the recruiter can go, right? So let's just say they have term. So you guys understand how term works. It's like you're renting a house,
mm-hmm.
right? You're gonna live in that house for 10, 15, 20, 25, or 30 years. Now what happens at the end of that lease period?
Well, usually it goes up.
Right, your rent goes up.
Right.
Okay, same thing here. Your rent's gonna go up. or you're gonna have to try and re-qualify for life insurance all over again. But now that you're older, how's your health?
Probably worse.
Right. So it might be harder for you to be insured, right? But now here are a few of the advantages with... It's her. She's already done. Really?
Oh, you're done? Oh,
all right. I'll wrap up this and then you can take over then because I have to guess. Okay. So, advantages. Great for the short-term needs, inexpensive upfront. Mm-hmm. So that means it can be very cost-effective while you're younger or if you just need that extra coverage, right? Now, the disadvantages are, you want to tell them? You want to help work out? Yeah. The disadvantages is after the term expires, your rates increase dramatically, mm-hmm. right? You're potentially uninsured. We just talked about that. It's like renting a home. 97% of people outlive their policy. So this is where insurance companies make a majority of their profits, mm-hmm. is through term life insurance. Because what happens typically to most people, they outlive their policies. Right?
That's a nugget right there.
Yes.
So someone that's term, that's a good way to go into permanent. Because 100% of the time it pays out. Where here 97% of the time it doesn't.
Right.
Exactly. You know, you can't outlive a permanent policy.
Right.
You know? So yeah.
Yeah, there you go. Right. Now, within term life insurance, so with us, we do have term with living benefits. I can go into a little bit more detail about that here in a couple minutes. The next type of life insurance is whole life or universal life. So this is permanent life insurance. So you own the house, right? Now here's a few of the catches to it. There's no cash accumulation for the first 5 years. So it's gonna be a while before you see a return because back in the 70s and 80s, what were they doing to sell whole life policies like Gerber? They sell this like a savings plan mm-hmm. for your kids, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now here's a few other things. Rate of return is fixed, 2-5%. That's how well the insurance company does, not how well the market does, right? So that means if the insurance company has a really great year in sales, you would get maximum
5%. Huh?
That's it. That's how they've made them, right? And if the insurance company didn't do so well, you're probably only getting 2%. So it's completely dictated by how well the insurance company. Now, if you need to borrow money from it, because remember they used to sell it as a savings plan, they charge you 6-8%. Can you imagine they're charging you more to borrow than you earn in interest? Mm-hmm. Makes no sense. Withdrawals may be delayed up to 6 months. You would think it's like, okay, I want my money, right? But it's gonna take potentially up to 6 months. And you have no control over that. Now, here's the reason why a lot of people don't like just insurance salesmen in general or life insurance in general is because these were sold as death benefit only, no cash value. Mm-hmm. So that means, imagine, right, CJ, if you got a $250,000 whole life policy and you had $150,000 cash value in there, something happened, you, God forbid, knock on wood, how much does your family get? Right. They don't get the 250 plus the 150. It's only 250 to your family. That's why a lot of people don't like it.
There's somewhere we can get the 150 to.
There is. That's a great question. Wow. It's actually the next type of life insurance that we offer. It's called Index Universal Life. So it's also permanent life insurance, but now here's the main difference between whole life and the Index Universal Life. Whole life's only good till 100. Index Universal Life's good till 121. So it's guaranteed to pay out as long as you live that long. Who's the oldest person in the family, by the way? How old are they?
Oh, probably 92.
Okay, so it probably makes sense to get a 91. Okay. So, permanent life insurance, no lapse guarantee. So that means as long as there's a bare minimum for you to just keep the policy, whereas, let's just say, in a whole life you miss one premium, it goes into a lapse and you could potentially lose the policy. Cash accumulates immediately, so from the day you make your first premium into the policy, right? Are you guys paying attention to what I'm doing with my hands?
Yeah.
From your very first premium that you put into the policy, you start earning interest on there. Okay? So you don't have to wait 5 years. It's immediate, right? Average rate of return of an IUL right now has been historically over the past 25 years, a little over 9%. By the way, that's dependent on how well the market does. Okay, but you have a floor of 0.75% and a cap of 15%. So you got a lot more earning potential, right? You have tax-free access through policy loans, right? So you can request to take a loan, kind of like you have a, because your previous military, you had a TSP, right? Imagine with the TSP, you had to pay back your loan, right? Here, you don't have to. By the way, and there's no charge on you taking the loan. Pretty cool, huh? Withdrawals can happen within 72 hours, and I'm speaking from personal experience. I had 5 clients last year all take loans from their policies. Personal experience. 2 of them took out roughly about 10 to 15 grand to put a down on their house. That's why you teach your clients to save a lot of money, because that will happen. Okay. And the last part, why so many people are taking advantage of this type of policy, is your beneficiaries will receive both your death benefit and your cash value. So if you're covered for a quarter million, CJ, and then you've built up another $150,000 cash value, something happens to you, what does your wife and your kids get? Right. So how much is that total?
Let's see.
$400,000,
all completely 100% tax-free.
Wow.
Okay. Now the question is, you guys own term right now. Do you own the right type of life insurance right now?
Probably not.
Okay, so what type of policy does it make sense to own?
Index universal life.
Okay, so what I would like to do is run numbers for you guys, find out what's gonna be affordable for you guys and how much coverage you guys are gonna need. So I need your date of birth, and then just roll.
What's this 7702 plan I hear about?
That's that.
Really?
How you well.
That's interesting.
Right? That's as simple as it goes. If somebody has life insurance, great. I commend you for having life insurance. But the question is, do you have the right type? And then you just go through it, you roll. Because this sells itself, guys. It really does. It really does. You know, I've sat down with people with whole life and term, they're like, okay, so how do I qualify for this? They're like, forget everything else, right? I want that, okay? So I'm gonna let Nick take over, so I'll pick one of you guys to come up. So Marky, why don't you come up and you can go play with Nick, and I have guests to attend to.
So why don't you do Byron's the client. So Byron, you stand up.
When you're done, stop, Michael. All right.
So Byron's the client, and then you're gonna switch, and then Byron, you're gonna do it back to Marky.
Okay, cool. All right, Byron, let me ask you a question. Do you have life insurance?
Yeah.
All right, that's awesome, man. What do you got?
Term.
Okay. When's the last time you talked to your agent?
It's been a while.
It's been a while? Okay. So tell me, what do you know about the type of life insurance that you have?
Well, I know term is only for a term.
For a term, right.
Time,
as of life.
Yeah, but that's pretty much it. All
right, well, I'm going to tell you a little bit more about it.
Oh,
so there's 3 main types of life insurance. Firstly, there's term insurance, which you've got, like you said, so for a period of time. The advantages to having term is that it's great, you know, for term, you know, it's going to be expensive up front, but there's a lot of disadvantages.
Oh, okay.
So which includes,
yeah,
it's going to go up. Potentially, it's going to be you're going to be uninsurable. And the big thing is 97% of people are going to be able to get the benefit. There is the option of doing a term with living benefits, but let's go ahead and talk about some of the other policies before we get to that. So there's whole life and there's universal life. It's permanent life insurance. You'll have it for your whole life. There is no cash accumulation for the first 5 years, so even though you're putting money in, you're not getting any cash value from that first 5 years. The rate of return is fixed based on how well the insurance company is doing, so that's generally 2-5%, which isn't terrible, but it's also not what's best. If you want to take a loan out of your cash value, there is going to be a percent of interest on that loan. The withdrawal could take about 6 months, so if you need money immediately, it's not going to be to your benefit. And then if you do pass, your beneficiaries are only going to get the face value, they're not going to get the cash value. There is a policy, however, that exists that is permanent. It will not lapse. If you miss a premium, cash accumulates as soon as you start putting money into it. The rate of return is based on the market, not the progress of the insurance company. So on average, you get 8 to 12% interest on your cash value. It'll bottom out at 0.75%. Is tax-free access. So if you need to take out a loan, you can take it out immediately, usually within 72 hours. There is no interest on that loan. That money is yours. Beneficiaries will receive not only the face value, the cash value as well. So say you're putting, you have 250,000 face value, you accumulate another 250,000. By the time you pass, your family gets $500,000. So, do you own the right kind of life insurance? So let's go ahead and see what we can do for you then in the universal life policy.
Boom.
Awesome.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. Good job, man. It's money.
Okay, Marky. Do you have a life insurance at the moment?
No, I don't. I don't know anything about life insurance.
You don't know anything?
Real quick, I want you guys to change the language. Don't ask if they have it. Ask them how much they got. So then they feel guilty when they say, "Actually, I don't have any." Then you do the jaw drop, like, "Oh, whoa, well, let's, all right." You know what I mean?
Okay.
So instead of saying, "Do you have it?" it's how much do you have? And then, because then it's more impactful when they say they ain't got any, they feel more guilty about not. You know? Yeah. There's a little psychological change. Yeah. It's big.
All right, so Marky, how much life insurance do you have at the moment?
I don't actually have it.
Wow. So basically, if something was to happen to your family, you'd get zero.
Yeah, my family.
Wow.
I make all the money in the house.
Okay, well, let me go through a couple of different types of life insurance. I know you don't have any at the well, but I know it might be something that you're going to think about after we go through.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, so there's the first type of life insurance is term. Term insurance only lasts you for a certain period of time, a certain time. It's either 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, 25, or 30. The advantages of term insurance is that it's great for short-term needs and a very inexpensive upfront. The disadvantage, however, is that after term expires, rates usually increase dramatically. And you can become potentially uninsurable because you're at a older age. 97% of people usually outlive their policy. So their insurance companies are making a lot of money off of term. There is an option of term with living benefits, but we'll get into that more after we go through a couple of other ones. There is a life insurance policy called Whole Life or Universal Life. It is permanent life insurance, but you get no cash accumulation for up to the first 5 years. Rate of return is fixed at 2 to 5%, and that's based on how good the insurance company does, not the market. And if you borrow money, they're gonna charge you a 6 to 8% interest rate. So actually they're charging you more than you're even getting in return. Withdrawal may be delayed up to 6 months, so if you needed immediate cash, you wouldn't be able to get it immediately. And your family, if something was to happen to you, they either get death benefit but no cash value. So even if you was to accumulate $100,000 in cash value and had a $200,000 death benefit, your family will only get the $200,000.
And all that other money would go to the insurance company.
Yes. The last insurance type of insurance that we have is called Index Universal Life Insurance. It is permanent life insurance. There's a no lapse guarantee. So like in the whole life, if you was to miss a payment within the first 5 years, it has the potential to lapse and then you would have no coverage. This has a no lapse guarantee. Cash accumulates immediately. So as soon as you start putting cash into there, you immediately start gaining, accumulating interest.
rate of return is between 8 to 12%. You know, so it does a whole lot better than a 2-5. And that's based on the market. You have tax-free access, so if you was to take money out of your policy, they won't charge you a dime. Mm-hmm. Withdrawals, usually within 72 hours. So if you need a cash immediately, you'll get it immediately. And then your beneficiaries receive, if something was to happen to you, the death benefit and cash value. So like I said, if you was to have $100,000 saved, and you was to have a $200,000 death benefit, your family would get $300,000 in the whole thing. That's my question to you, Mark. So which one would you like? So which one would you like out of the three?
Definitely that last one. Let's get started.
Awesome. Let's get rolling.
All right. Give me a hand. Give me a hand. So one of the things, too, to kind of enroll someone or to transition after you've done this is say, tell you what, let's do this. And that's how that transitions you to say, you know, go into running numbers. You know, if they have the insurance, then, you know, pulling out their policies, you know, is something that you should definitely do. Especially like if they're like, hey, well, yeah, this one sounds better. Okay, so you said you had a term. Can you get out the term? You know, let's kind of look and see. You know, let's just kind of double check, because then, I mean, the proof's in the pudding. You know, when you can show them that it's going to increase after the, you know, the years of the term, and then transitioning into running the numbers is big. You know, because you want to ideally, that's the money maker. You know, the big money maker, the big close really is you running that illustration. Mm-hmm. You showing this is what you're going to put in, this is what you're going to have at the end. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. But the more you understand this, you did a great job, you know, all you guys are doing a great job. So it's all about just constantly improving in these things. Because if we go through all these little slides and you know how to pop this one, pop that one, then you're just gonna be more versed no matter who you're sitting with. You're sitting out with someone on a one-on-one, you're like, okay. You're just, you know, the mentality is more important than anything, you know? Because if you really are sold out to it and you get it, then you don't have to necessarily memorize it, although you know it, but it's gonna come more natural. It's gonna come more natural through repetition. So that's where it's at.